Hello, it's 9 p.m. Pacific, midnight Eastern, and it's time for the show that brings you the best deals in vaping. Broadcast from the Vapor Joe's Bunker in the heart of New Jersey and coming at you from the Vaping Underground Live Network on YouTube. I'm your host and deals diva, Tiger Tiger, and with me, as always, is the infamous, proudly politically incorrect, and always devilishly handsome Vapor Joe. So grab a vape, a beverage, and don't touch that dial. You're in for 90 minutes of interactive, informative, and money-saving vape chat. Welcome to Done Deal.
By the way, you don't have to keep me muted because I mute every time you talk.
What do you mean?
I can see you're muting me. It's
well,
live. It's live on air.
I do. You know what? I'll be really honest. I'll be straight up with you. The fact of the matter is, I'm careful with you because I know you'll say something absolutely stunningly inappropriate while I'm trying to do our intro.
She'll be talking. I'll just be like, poop. Stunningly incorrect poop. Are we bringing in Scope?
Well, if he's game, I noticed he was able to jump in at the last there. And yeah, absolutely. If Scope's still in the room and wants to join us for a bit, that's totally cool.
Yeah, I didn't get to do the email tonight, guys, to announce that the deal was going on tonight, so the numbers are going to be low. But we'll deal with it. 53 is I.
Well, you know, low numbers. This is the elite crew. These are the people that want to be here.
Everybody wants to be here because we don't do any giveaways. We're the only show, I think. Are we the only one?
One of the very few, I think. Yeah.
Occasionally we do giveaways because I have like a shit ton of juice that I don't want to go bad. But normally speaking, we have zero sponsors. Mm-hmm. On the show, there's only one sponsor, the biggest sponsor in the vaping industry, Vapor Joe's, the Vapor Joe's Network, the biggest entity in vaping, but still, it doesn't matter. Anyway, so is Sir Scope want to come on?
Well, I'm just watching chat because I didn't connect with him outside of, so I'm just watching chat to see if he's still there and might want to jump in.
Hell no, he was just like, peace, I'm hitting the pool.
Hot tub, yeah.
Now, did he go with Mrs. Scope?
No.
Oh, he's gone. Goodbye. He's gone. He's hitting a bar. He's going in the pool. Peace.
Oh,
see ya.
Come on now. Maybe he's calling.
He's at the bar. You know who I know? You know those bands? All these bands I used to hook up with and hang out with? I used to be the drum tech, man. You want a drink?
You are just stirring shit. Just stirring shit. There he is.
Yeah, he's out there for work.
He's
working
his ass off. Scope, you're welcome to join us for a bit if you want to.
If you're bored. You don't have to. I'm just saying if you're bored.
Absolutely. The invitation's open. You just holler. Actually, you don't even have to holler. You know how to find me on VC. Just...
You got Tiger's private number. Super
That's
private.
Right. That's right.
That's where the nudes are.
The red phone.
She's got
the now.
Anyway, so welcome to Done Deal. We have a lot to talk about tonight, but let's get into bait now while we find out what's... Oh, Scope is coming in.
I am actually out here for work. What the hell?
That means nothing. Means nothing. Yes, from work, from like 9 to 5, and after that it's called personal time.
Yeah, personal time is you're watching personal time. I'm sitting in this chair in my hotel room, which is
so you got an efficiency. You got a kitchen and everything.
Yeah, this hotel is actually pretty new. It's the Residence Inn in Tempe. It is nice.
What does a married man in Arizona need with an efficiency? Unless he's cooking and he has a beer full of fridge. I mean, a fridge full of beer.
It's completely empty. There's not a thing in it.
I'm telling Courtney. That's it. That's all over.
No, they actually, my company cut a deal with this place. So they told us, you are staying here. We didn't have a choice. It's not like we could go book our own, hotels or anything. It's, you're staying here. So it's, and you have to call this number and say it's this Limelight rate, yada yada. So Yeah, if anything, I would have chosen the not-so-nice place that's a lot closer, so I wouldn't have to walk a quarter mile in this blazing heat each way.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, what's it like out there? Like, how bad is it?
It is brutal right now, because normally it's always hot. Like, every time I come out here, it's like 110, 115, but it's usually, like, no humidity. But now there's actually humidity, too, which makes it really bad.
Dude, 100, could you picture 115 degrees with, like, 99% humidity?
Every
like,
time
old
I go
people...
out... Oh, every time I go outside to vape, like the second the door opens, your face is in shock. You're like, your body goes, no, this is not normal. It's really
it's terrible. Oh, I couldn't handle that. I mean, even in Jersey at 80 with 100% humidity, it's like you take a shower, you walk outside, I need a shower.
You know what's weird? The first thing I noticed, like walking to the place, because it's, you know, it's a quarter mile from here, so I have to walk each way. I went out and it's so hot, and then you vape and vapor is cold, and I realized real quickly that I could use the vapor to actually cool myself. So all you have to do is position yourself so the wind's coming at you this way, and then you blow out and the vapor goes like this, and it actually cools you off because vapor is so cold.
Yeah,
you know, it's weird, and I've been vaping for all these years and I've never noticed the temperature difference, but because it's so hot here, you can feel it. When the vapor touches you, it actually cools you off.
Yep.
It's weird.
I've noticed that in the summer several times. Yeah, that's a plus. Well, at least it's working for you. See, vaping just has untold benefits.
Yeah, exactly. It's personal air conditioning. I'm in my hotel, so I gotta be like stealthy about my vape.
Yeah, that's right. And, you know, we won't mention anything about, you know, strange use of shower caps or, you know, anything that could get anyone.
Oh,
or the go-go dancer or hookers. But, you know,
I wouldn't even know what you're talking about.
No,
shower
of course
cap.
Not.
That's only
of
for
course
showers,
not.
Right?
Yeah, that's, of course. Yeah, absolutely. You know, want to keep your hair from being frizzy, you know, just saying. Yeah. So.
Where's Scope? Scope is in Amsterdam, and he's in the red light district.
Yeah, and, yeah, this definitely, I've been to the red light district, and it does not look like this. I'm in Tempe, Arizona right now.
Is it fun? Are you having a good time?
As good as can be expected when you're doing nothing but work all day.
He's sitting there, and he's like, well, the company could be moderate. Yeah. Yes, fantastic, fantastic time. It's the best ever. I've never seen anything like this. It's puppet shows. Yeah.
And most of them have no idea, like, about the shows or any of the stuff that I do. They just think I'm just one of the guys. They know I vape, that's it. But there's a lot of, you know, it's funny. There's a lot of my coworkers do vape out here, but most of them aren't, like, that into the gear. Like, one guy, actually, I was surprised. One guy had a pretty current setup. I saw a guy with a Reloe, and I think he had the new Crown. You know, he didn't even know what it was called, but, you know, I guess the shop told him to buy it, and he bought it, and he liked it, so... So I was surprised to see one guy with a pretty modern setup. Another guy still rocking a tube mod, that one weird one that came out a while ago. The Aspire one. You know that one? Joe, you have one. That weird Aspire, like, just, it's kind of like...
It's just a tall battery.
Yeah. But like a five-click on one. But it doesn't have any, you know, screen.
Yeah, it's just like a regular, it's a sub-ohm battery, but it's a big fat ego.
Yeah, but we have quite a
big fat ego battery that lets you sub on.
We got quite a few. So we all, the paper's kind of like go in the quarter, but they have no idea who I am, like, you know, juice making part of it or the, you know, the shows or any of it. They're just another guy that vapes. Yeah, it's interesting.
I just zeroed in on Joe talking about a big fat ego. I'm like, well, there is something you can identify with.
Well, yes, my ego. Well, see, Tucker, you know, when I get up in the morning, my ego eats breakfast with me. And eats half my breakfast and part of my coffee. You know,
it's true.
At least I admit it.
Yes, he tells no lies.
Yeah, most men are like, I'm not egotistical. I'm totally egotistical, but I admit it. At least I tell you. You know, it's like
you gotta give
me props for that.
And you somehow think that's endearing.
Well, no, it's just being truthful. Just being truthful. That's all I'm saying. I'm also a dick. Anyway, so anyway, while Scope's here, let's go into vape mail, because I want to get this out of the way, because it's not going to be long, because I'm the only one who has vape mail, right?
Well, pretty much. I guess the only thing I could ask our viewers is, did I talk about this marvelous little number last week, the Omega from Lotus Vaping? Yeah, and Joe is in the background muted, asking, on Done Deal, not Mod Envy. And Scopes got one too. I can't remember if I told you guys about this. If I didn't, I need to.
And hey, why do you think I only brought three mods, and this is one of them? Why do you think that is?
Look at that shit.
You know why I brought this? Because this is such a great form factor. This, like, just super light. I like the fact that not only does it not take up a lot of space in your pocket, but it's super, like, you don't even feel it in your pocket. It's really light. So, yeah, I brought this.
Yeah, no weight to it really at all, and yet there's still 2,200 mAh at your disposal. I'm enjoying mine thoroughly, too. If you guys are looking for a step-up device or even a really, really boss starter device for somebody, these go for $29.99. The whole kit, the atomizer with the matched seals and the Omega mod. Now, what's nice about this is also what's super simple about it. There's no adjustments. There's no wattage up, wattage down. There's a button to push to vape. End of story. And a USB in the bottom to charge. End of story. Charge, press button, vape. There's no instruction necessary with this other than how to fill the tank. Now, the one drawback I would say is that it is a bottom fill tank. I remove it completely to refill. You know, top fill would have been great, but hey, you can't ever have everything. And for $30, this is a killer kit. So there you go. So unless...
No scope. If you want to vape, the best place to vape in your... I know you can't do it right now, but the best place to vape is the bathroom. Because there's no
detectors
fire,
in there.
Like fire detectors in there.
Just to show you, too, just to give Oscar a little more love, I only brought three other bottles besides my cola. So I brought this, I brought the Voltage, and then I brought one of Gary's. I brought Main Squeeze. And my cola, that's all I brought for the trip, because it's only, 4 days. That's more than enough.
And for those of you who want to see what the... I didn't open mine. For those of you who want to see what it looks like in the kit, it looks just like this. All purdy. And I'm going to wind up giving this away to some kind of new vapor somewhere, somehow. I don't think I'm going to do it online. I'm just going to find somebody smoking and just be like, hey, put out that cigarette. Try this.
And one last comment on this mod. Can you imagine, Joe, when you and I started vaping, that you could get something like this for $29?
No, because like, my first setup was $169, my first Ego T. I think I started vaping Joe's.
Yeah, mine was like 100 and change for a Halo setup. That was the Halo Triton, which is their Ego with a little Kanger T2 top, but branded Halo, but that's what it really was the Kanger T2. And like a little starter thing of juice, and it was like well over 100. And this is, $29. It's just crazy.
Yeah, shows absolutely. You how far we've come. My first kit was an Ego W 2 pens kit, so you could switch off, have two flavors going. I spent $36 American. I ordered it from China, waited probably 5 weeks for it to come. I was so stoked, and this thing blows it away. I mean, ridiculous. I was so impressed with what we had then, but baby, we have come a long way.
Oh, yeah.
So, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
So what else? Does anybody else have any vape mail?
I have tons of vape mail. Well, I have a few.
All right,
so I got my Playboy mod. For those of you who didn't see this on Mod Envy, I've been looking for this mod forever. It had to be in this specific color. It had to be in this specific design. This is the Playboy mod in brown and rose gold. That was the keeper for me. It's 150-watt mod. I picked up my Vapor Beast for about about $35. It used to be $100. It has like a leather, I don't know if you can see it, but it's kind of like a leathery design with the Playboy bunnies, the rose gold. Absolutely gorgeous. The bottom, it takes 2 18650s. Such a beautiful device. It just reminds me of like those 1950s on the table. They would have a big lighter sitting there. You know what I mean? Like, one of those big fat lighters that people would do back in the day when it was still stylish to smoke. This is like a table piece. It's absolutely gorgeous.
I can't wait to see that in person.
Yeah, it's gorgeous. It matches my watch, which is one thing I love. My Invicta watch, my Aqua. So another reason why I like it. Now, with this, I bought a bottle of Holy Grail RY4 from Vaporbeast. This is where I got the mod from. Holy Grail RY4. This is an old school vape. This, for those of you who like RY4s, this is kind of like tobacco meets a brownie. That's the best way I can explain it. It's a very sweet RY4. But they give you a little unicorn bottle, so I put it in here instead of leaving. I like unicorns way better than drippers for filling tanks, so I put it in here. So that's Vaporbeast. And then I'm going to kind of mix the next thing with the deal that's going on. So I'm going to put the, I'm going to put it in the room right now. Just give me a second here. Let me tell you something. Mount Baker Vapor is doing an insane deal. And from this deal, it's still going, I bought 236 mils of something called Freckled Lemonade. Okay? Freckled Lemonade is a, they call it like a, maybe a strawberry or a berry. This 236 mil bottle cost me $18. Okay?
I love it.
Okay, 15 mils will cost you $2. 30 mils will cost you $4, and 18 and 236 mils will cost you $18. This is one of my favorite flavors. If you like lemonade, it is a very strong lemonade.
I love lemon. I love a good lemonade.
And especially in this time of year. And they have all the, you know, PGVG ratios you like, flavor boosting, nic levels, all that good stuff. I've been buying from Mount Baker Vapor for a very, very long time. I actually have another bottle here that I bought from them. This is something called Grappler, which is a grape apple, which I bought on their last deal, which is really good. So if you got to check it. You got to be fucking stupid not to check them out. USA made. They've been around forever.
Those guys are here now, aren't they? I think when all the shit went down in Washington State, I think they relocated. I thought I heard they went to Arizona.
No. They still are. I think they're still up there.
Are they? I thought I heard they had to move because of something with Washington State. I thought I read a whole thing on that, but I could be wrong about that. Or maybe they were going to. All right, so Ginger's confirming what I said. Yeah, they are in AZ.
Okay.
I remember I'm on their mailing list, and I remember when they sent the big email about this. They're in Mesa, which is right here. I'm in Tempe, so I could go see them. That's weird.
So here's a question I have then. Then why did they send me a graphic? The Summit of the Northwest Vaping.
Yeah.
Why did they send it to me?
That's right. That's like a town. I could take the light rail. I'd go outside, take the light rail, and go see.
My point is why did they send me a graphic that says the Summit of Northwest Vaping? Yeah, Arizona is not Northwest.
Maybe they didn't update the graphic yet. They were. up there for the longest time.
Yeah,
but,
for sure.
They had to get out because of the state. The regulations of Washington State got really bad for them. And considering the volume they do, it was worth it for them to just go somewhere else.
Now, some people's all right, but there's a difference between, where they're incorporated and where they make their juice. You know, some people say, you know, they're in a Suite 101 in Mesa, Arizona. That easily could be a UPS store. I'm just saying.
You know,
and somebody like Mount Baker Vapor, because I talked to them, would need their own building. They get tankers that come in and fill the floor. The underground with VG, PG, and Nick. This
wow.
is how much juice they pull out. They do, I remember talking to them, they do 6 to 10,000 bottles a day.
Oh my God.
Okay?
I would die.
Do this, you know, they would need their own floor somewhere.
All right, BBB found the post on the move. That's it right there.
Okay,
oh, nicely done, Big Bam. Oh, I kind of hate to think of them relocating because I know from where I live in Canada, I can see Mount Baker from my back door. Nowhere to lie. I am that close to the border, and I always think of them when I see it. So, but I mean, you got to do what you got to do.
All right, it was dated June 2nd, 2015 is when they sent out the release.
Okay.
So, yeah, they've been here for a little bit.
All right, so anyway, here's the deal. Listen, guys, I have no idea how long this deal is going to last. But for $2.99 for 15 mils, $4 for 30 mils, and if you do enjoy a flavor that's on that list, to get 236 mils, which I did, I bought it. No, they did not send this for free. I paid for this. $18 out the door. You can't beat it, man. It's a great deal. And, you know, they're a great company. All right. Now, is there anything else? Let's see here. Oh, yes. And for those of you who are into numismatics, I got the newest and the greatest, most wonderful coin from Canada that came out with a Superman logo. For those of you who do know me very well, I love silver. I collect silver. I buy bars and all kinds of stuff. Love this. Been loving this for a long time. Canada makes some great fucking coins. I love Canadian coins. And it's not just because I married one.
No, not just because of that?
Not just because of that.
All right, just checking, because you just mock Canada in my presence. Pisses me off.
I do. I mock Canada all the time. However, they do good things.
Blame Canada.
Exactly. Remember that? What I need to do is I got to call up those guys and have Tiger talk with the head that moves up and down just one time. You know what I'm talking about?
Do I need to do a flappy head?
Do myself as Ike?
Yes. Yeah. Be like Ike and yelling at me at the same time. All right, so I think we're done with Vape Mail.
I got one thing. I showed it before, but I got the Boreas tank. I actually brought it out here with me, but this thing's pretty awesome. 25mm rebuildable only tank, but the one thing about it that's really cool and unique is that the airflow control ring actually also controls the juice flow inside. So what you can do to be really sneaky and clever about it is say I like the straw for my air, right? But say I want more juice, I could go to the four holes like this. But then just to say, because I have four holes doesn't mean I have to have them all the way open. So I could close them off like that. And now I've got the same draw as the two wide open holes, but now I've got more juice flow than I had before. So in my mind, it's really two separate controls, a separate juice flow control and a separate airflow control, when you factor in that trick of that you could go to the four hole and then just kind of partially block them. So it's really, really cool. And then if you go like this and shut it all the way, it's completely shut. So when you refill it, you're not as likely to flood out, because it's literally closed access of the juice to get into where the coil is.
So it's all about the holes.
Top fill. It's got like all the goodies. It's got a killer velocity deck. It actually comes with two different decks. One has 2mm holes in the bottom and one has 2.5. So if you're doing like crazy high builds or really, really thick juice, you can switch decks to the other deck they give you that has extra, you know, can feed even faster with the 2.5mm holes. So really, really like it. This was all because of Scuba. He was the one to talk me into it. But apparently they stopped making these. So like once they're sold out, they're gone and that's it. So, great.
Or until they're cloned.
Or yeah, which I'm sure will happen.
Until they're cloned.
Yeah.
All right. Just looking at some tracking information on some Vape Mail that I have.
Yeah, D-Millen has. Well, a few people in chat have this tank. Because Scuba was raving about it, so a bunch of us got them.
All right,
yeah, Scuba raves about something, usually I go and get it. I listen to him.
I forget how many RXs he has now. The best advertisement for the RX-200.
He's got mad issues.
Well, you know, it's nice to have a mod per tank. For every tank you have a mod for it.
Yeah.
That's just the way it
is. True that.
My current problem is I think I'm higher. I get out of balance all the time. Right now I have more tanks that I would like to run than I have mods that are capable of running those tanks. That's the key word. Like, I have mods, but not that are accurately going to drive that device, you know? So I'm in a deficit for tanks again. I should probably get another one of that. I tell you what, I still love this thing a lot. I love the cuboid. I really, really like the form factor on it.
I love the idea you could just dump juice into it and never have to worry about it. Like, you could just pull pull everything out and you still dump juice right into it and it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, the cuboid.
Yeah,
I get the cuboid and the cubit.
I know, you always get those two. Well, they start the same way, they end differently, but Oid is the mod, and Is the tank,
yes, yes.
Is the tank.
I have them both, which is annoying. I have one here, and I just, it's like, is this the cuboid? Ugh. Fuck off! Why do you gotta call them the same thing?
Yeah.
Well, that's China for you. Anyway, fuck them. So anyway, there is a new baby mod out there. Now, what do I mean by a baby mod? Well, you guys know about the Nugget, and you know about the Mini Volt. Well, there's a new one. Vaporesso, guys who make the Target, have come out with the Vaporesso Target Mini. It's a baby mod. I ordered one. It should hopefully be here before Mod Envy next week. Bought it off eBay. So, again, I'm a victim of my own deals. And I picked it up here.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, and in terms of how a small, teeny... It's a teeny mod. It's a baby mod. In terms of how they
watts
look...
And 0.10, 80 watts and 0.10...
No, it's 40 watts. 40 watts.
Oh. I'm reading the description underneath. It says... Am I looking at the wrong thing? Oh, I'm looking at the Vapor Kessa 80 watt TC, 8 bucks... I don't know. I just clicked the link from Big Bang Boom.
So. No, look at my link. This one's a baby, teeny baby mod. It's got a 1400 mAh battery built in.
It's like a really sexy little version of this when you get right down to it.
Yeah, and this is the fashion right now. It's small, it's portable, it does temperature control, it's got the wattage, it's got the LiPo battery built in. And I was having a hard time figuring out which one I want. And I wound up buying the silver. Because the black was cool, but the black kind of looks like a toy. With the red buttons. Kind of reminds me of something I could buy at the dollar store. You know, I just had that red button.
I like the triangle buttons. That's kind of neat, that extra third button there, which I'm curious now what it does.
Usually maybe it switches between wattage and or what have you. It goes to the menu system.
Oh, that would be so slick. I would love if somebody would do that because I hate the key the button combinations to switch to wattage.
When you have a million mods and each one of them has a different way of switching modes, it's really like some of them are the 3-click. So you have to remember 5 is off and on, but 3 is change mode on some of them. But on other ones, it's fire and up for one thing and fire and down for another. And trying to keep that all straight in your head when you've got all these different brands is not easy. Sometimes I have to Google it, you know.
It's so true. I pride myself on not reading manuals, and that's part of my mark of how I review a new mod too. And what I think of it is, can I operate this without reading any of the instructions? And it's funny, you get your old ones set up the way you want and then you revisit them and it's like, how the hell do I do this again? So as long as it's simple, that's a big plus.
Right.
My wife the other day put the jelly slice and got it into voltage mode somehow, and that took me a minute to like get it back into wattage.
Yeah, for sure.
I thought you were gonna tell me your wife put the jelly slice in the toaster.
Stop!
If she does that,
stop!
Oh boy.
I may have to get the stick Tony told me about to whack you with.
Yeah.
Anyway, but seriously, for those of you who are into these mini mods, I have them all, and I don't have this one, but this one just looks the slickest of them all so far, and I can't wait to get it. I mean, the Mini Volt was great, and then we came out with the Nugget. The Nugget had 1,000 mAh and temperature control. This one now has 1,400 mAh, has all the other accoutrements, so plus the way it looks, it just looks fantastic. So I had to pick myself up one, so I got the silver one. So hopefully, since it's eBay, hopefully it'll be here before Saturday. Who knows?
And hopefully he gets tired of it really early on, so that it ends up on my desk.
Yeah, that's usually what happens. Anyway, now somebody put in P. Bisardo did a review. You know what? P. Bisardo is not allowed to review anything anymore. He's a juice maker. Okay, he's not a reviewer anymore. He's a juice maker. So if Bebisauro does anything about reviews, it's null and void. He's a juice
maker. Now hold on. I think only his juice reviews are null and void at this point. I mean, he can still talk about hardware. He's not in. He doesn't have his fingers in.
How do you know
game.
That?
Well, I don't. I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt at this point. But yeah, any juice reviews he does from this point forward mean nothing.
Well, actually, conveniently, he stopped doing juice reviews quite a while ago. Like once in a while, he'll like unofficially talk about one, but he stopped doing the real like scoring them and everything quite some time. So I have a feeling he's been planning this one for a while.
Well, no, he was like, shit, August is coming, I gotta get into it. But I still don't understand that bullshit about August. I mean, I just think if you're a reviewer, Grimm, only person who can get away with it is Grimm because he did it many, 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 many years ago. Anybody else out there who does a juice line, you're a reviewer, you've just sold out. Sorry, but you did. Anyway, let's just see. What else? What else is out there, Tiger? I'm putting you on the spot. I'm kidding.
Seriously? Ask Big Bam. He's got a better idea right now.
No. I have plenty of deals. Just some of them have gone south on me.
I'm just minding my business, drinking my Chardonnay, trying to run a broadcast here. You know, hello.
All right, so the replacement had 33% off sale over at Mount Baker Vapor is over. But there is a new sale. I'll be posting it tomorrow. I don't have all the coupon codes yet or everything, but I know that all their tanks are 20% off now. I'll be posting that tomorrow at some point. But the replacement heads... what does your wife call replacement heads, Scope?
Changers.
Yes, all changers are 33% off.
I think we should make that stick, like hashtag changers. Like, that's the new... She's like, yeah, and I got my changer for... She just called it that, like, not even thinking about it. She was like... Yeah, Craig, Scope got me the changers for my Clea, whatever it is, tank that I have.
I love it. She's so humble. She always says she doesn't know anything, and I love the fact that she's driving the nomenclature. That's great.
But I always say this, yeah, that's true about hardware, but she knows juice, you know, whether she wants to admit it or not. She knows good juice from bad juice. Better than a lot of people do, and she is very useful at helping me mix it, because she's real good at, even though she doesn't know any of the text side of it, she's real good if you identify the notes in it. She's real good at telling you if you brought this note up and that note down a little bit, you know, it would be really good. And she's always right.
Just saying. Exactly. I'm so glad she's working with you. You two are a dynamic duo. My addiction right there.
Yep.
All right, so getting away from the little baby mod, let's talk about Jaelic. Jaelic is doing the, I'm calling it this, he didn't call it this, I'm just calling it the Summer of Fun Sale. Because he can tend to be dry. So I'm calling it the Summer of Fun Sale. All flavors, not just his specific flavors that he's doing, all 250 flavors are $11 for 100 mils. Okay? Those of you who know Jaelic, well, he's a man from Israel. He is an Hasidic Jew, which means he is practices when it comes to making things in I would assume are kosher, which means very clean. And I've vaped a ton of his juice. I know Tiger has. I have. Scope, I'm sure you have vaped a lot of his some of his juice at least. So
Ecto Cooler is awesome. I love that one.
Yeah, actually, I have a bottle of Ectocooler right here at 100 mils, and it's like, you know, just above a Conterre. I don't got a whole lot of it left.
Please use the proper terminology.
All right, it's about 6 mils left in the bottle.
That just makes me cringe.
I don't have the cunt hair to milliliter translation handy. If anybody knows what it exactly is, I don't know if it's like a 0.5 milliliter or 1 milliliter.
And by the way, I didn't invent that word. I just want to let you know.
It doesn't matter if you invented it. You keep using it.
It's a Jersey thing. Anyway, so...
It is kind of Jersey.
It's a Jersey thing.
And we have some Jelik on the way. It is shipped and on its way, and I can hardly wait. Some new flavors. Joe's got a few new ones coming. I've got Jamaican rum and vanilla cupcake on their way, and I'm really stoked to try them. Thank you, Jelik.
Yeah, I got some banana nut, and I also got a few flavors for my brother, who I'm still trying to come over to the light side. He still smokes, but he vapes too. And I got him some red tobacco, which is going to be a Marlboro flavor, and a double RY4. And I got myself some banana nut, which is really good, because I've had his banana Foster. Well, I'm assuming it's going to be really good, because I've had his banana Foster, which is fantastic. So now, he's out of Israel. Shipping is fast, believe it or not. His shipping is quick. 5-6 days tops. It's gonna take anywhere in the world.
Well,
roughly, that's what I think.
Would you say anywhere in the world? I mean, across the pond, you're here on the East Coast. It used to take a little bit longer for me in Canada on the West Coast, but still, when you consider it's coming from Israel, I was always impressed with his shipping. It was always fast. And I will tell you this. We only had our order placed, I think it was 5:30 p.m. on a Sunday, and it was on its way. I had an email telling me it was shipped by before 8 a.m. the next morning. I'm like, dude, it's not even been 12 hours. Really, really on the ball. Very quick shipping.
Do you really trust Jews made in Israel? Fuck yeah, I do, because I love the, number one, I support Israel 100%. Palestine can go kill themselves. And number two, you know, I'm a big fan of his juice, because I've vaped it quite often. This is the way it is.
Well, not only that, but all of his juice is made to kosher standards, which, you know, now I'm not that up on what that exactly means, but I am aware of some of the cleanliness standards. And when you talk about kosher standards, you're talking about a lot of stuff that comes down to really high clean standards. So yeah, anything Jelik mixes, I will vape, no questions asked. Do I trust it? Implicitly, yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Another thing I like about him is he does the, which I think is really cool, especially if you know how to DIY. You can order those extra flavor shots, which is basically the flavor concentrate that's used to make that juice, which its intended use is to boost the flavor if you want to make it stronger than he normally makes it. But there's nothing to stop you to, you know, throw a little VG in there, and you could make more juice. So, you know, you could make a little extra Zero Nick if you wanted to have it as an example with it, you know.
Now, somebody wrote in the root, Grant's Vanilla Custard stopped shipping. What does that mean? Like, they're out of business? Are they only selling to local shops?
If I'm not mistaken, Grant's was out of the EU. Specifically Great Britain in there. So perhaps regulations have or circumstances have stopped them from shipping?
Oh, they're just shipping to friends now. Oh, whatever. The guy made enough money. The funny thing is, actually, I saw a post by Tristan today on Facebook. He's like, what are you going to do when the FDA steals your NIC from you and you can't DIY anymore? I was like, buy from China and India?
Well, not only that, but I mean, I have to do a shameless plug for one of my favorite juice vendors. And of course, one of them is with us tonight right here, Scope 666.
Oh, stop.
And, you know, I don't have to tell you, I've shown it twice tonight, my addiction, Mad Scope. But if you love Grant's Vanilla Custard, you now take this down, write this down. You need to try DSV Creations G Money. Okay?
They can't buy it.
It is called G Money. Hey, listen, right now, DSV Creations is unable to take American payments. That is a problem. I will admit it. But you need to make a Canadian friend. If you love Grant's Vanilla Custard, you need to embrace a Canadian. We're very lovable people, and get them to ship you some of DSV Creations G Money. It is absolutely the bomb, measures up in every way to Grant's, and in my very humble opinion, surpasses it. So there you have it.
Well, I think Grant's Vanilla Custard is what basically started the custard trend in the country, around the world, basically. I was never a fan of custard. I mean, I like, you know, eating custard's good. You know, creme brulee and stuff like that's nice. But vaping it for me was just, I'm a contrarianist. Anything that's popular, I don't want to vape it. You know what I mean? So, you know, it was a custard. I'm like, and they actually bought a domain, fuckcustard.com. There was a picture of me there.
So, I should see if that still redirects or not. Last time I checked it, it still worked.
I vape. I'll vape something custardy if it's not called custard, only because I didn't want to be part of the in-group, you know? I'd rather be a part of the out-group. Like, for instance, I remember when Absinthe and Pluid was in fashion, I didn't vape it. Now I vape the shit out of all kinds of Absinthe and Pluid and black licorice flavors because it's awesome. You know? I like vaping on the out.
And Big Bam is asking, is it 100... And dollar sign is in there, G Custard. No, it's just called G Money. And you know what? While Joe looks for the next deal, I'm going to go get you a link. Okay? Okay.
Okay. Well, I'm going to look for a link right now.
Okay. 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 Okay.
Okay. Okay. Let's see where we're at. Let's see if this one's still going. That's the problem. I have to always see if my shit is still going. Okay. So this one's kind of an odd mod. But for the price, I think it's kind of damn good. I'm going to throw it in the room. I'm calling this an odd mod. Basically, this is the Vapor Kessa 80-watt box mod. It basically kind of looks like a fat person walking down the street. It has this kind of like wobbly, side-bowing form factor. But the draw for me was 80 watts and temperature control for $18.67. Shipped from America. This is not Chinese. This is from Vapor Beast. And I have to tell you, I could see the chip that's in it. It's the same chip that's in a ton of different mods. It's just in a different case. And for the price, you can't go wrong. I mean, that's cheaper than some juice out there. Like, you can get a mod cheaper than some people charge for a 30 mL bottle of juice. Okay, and I was actually thinking about picking up a bunch of these for giveaways. But I just didn't get around to it. Because today is my day off. I don't want to go into that right now.
I'll let you deal with it.
No, I want you to elaborate on why 80 watts is awesome for $18.
All right, you do that. You do that.
No, I want you to elaborate why 80 watts is awesome for $18.
For $18? Are you kidding me? I still remember when we were telling you guys not to pay more than $1 a watt, which would make this worth $80. $18? You're talking about 4 watts for the dollar plus a few bonus. That's a no-brainer, absolutely. I remember when the prices dropped to 2 watts for a dollar for a mod. Like a 100-watt mod would go for $50. Now you're telling me an 80-watt mod goes for under $20? That's absolutely stellar. That's very exciting.
I want to know what the hell that symbol is in the side. Is it a big coin or something? I want to know what the hell that symbol is.
It looks like a very official seal or something. It does.
It looks like a quarter
or something. Very, well, hang on. I think I'm going to have to follow your link and see what we can make of it. Well, you talk.
I just want to know what that thing is on the side. But, yeah, like I said, I've seen this chipset in a bunch of mods. And for $18, hey, Scope, you should buy your wife one. Give her to her for vape mail. It's cheap.
Yeah, it's cool.
He's like, hey, what is this? It's vape mail, honey, for you. Came in your name.
Poor Scope. Yeah. I mean, I do feel for you. You know, that's all I can say.
She loves to bust my chops about the bait mill all the time.
Yes, she does, and she is really, really good at it.
Oh, yeah. Well, some of it is, you know, let's just say she's perceptive, and she knows that. I think chat really eats up when, like, chat loves when she busts my chops, you know, and she knows the chat loves that, so she likes to turn the heat up on me, like, sometimes during the shows, because she knows that it gets, you know, the chat is thoroughly entertained by it, at my expense, but hey.
Now, Tiger, Caitlin Brigham wants to know, are we giving away a mod tonight? The answer is no.
Not that I'm aware of.
We do not give away anything on mod, Done Deal. Nothing. Zero. Usually zero. We sometimes give away
what we give away is incredibly valuable information on where you can get the best deals in
vaping,
Caitlin. If you're here strictly for giveaways, you'll be disappointed.
Yeah, go over to another channel, because this is not a giveaway show. We have one on Saturday. It's called Mod Envy, which should make up for every vape show in the history of mankind, because we give away $1,000 worth of stuff. But tonight, we just talk about deals. So that means you got to buy shit. Sorry. Sorry, you got to pull out your wallet.
Yeah, but they're good deals. It's worth watching.
Right.
I have to be just in the right place when I click to unmute my mic, and I got a better view of what that medallion looks like. So there you go. There you go, Joe. Oh, come on. Now they're showing me coupons. Go away, coupon. There you go. All right. It gives you a little bit of an idea. I don't think it's quite coin-like, but it's definitely a medallion detail on that Kisa or Kesa 80 watt.
Is this still going? Yes, it's still going. I cannot believe it. All right, I gotta talk about this.
You're muted.
Fuck. Sorry, guys. We're in the same room, so I mute myself. I have to talk about this. Listen, if you don't buy this, you're fucking moronic. Okay, that's all I'm going to say. You're a fucking moron. And I'll explain to you why. So here it is. Just for vape mail, okay? This is a 6-in-1 coil maker, okay? A jig. $4.13 shipped from America for free. Okay, so you get a 6-in-1 coil maker, you get all the lovely different posts and tops and all that stuff shipped from America for free for $4.13. Fuck you if you don't buy this. I bought one and I don't even fucking rebuild.
He absolutely does not rebuild. That is the truth, and it is hilarious that he bought one. But seriously, I am let me say I'm a retired rebuilder, because I cut my teeth rebuilding. It's still where my heart is, but practicality with the great new tanks has led me away from it. But if you rebuild, this is an incredible deal. At just over $4, you've got everything. I mean, I remember when sets like this were starting at like in the $25 range and coming down from there. So at $4 to get everything you're getting in this kit, yeah, absolutely. I mean, yeah. I was paying in the neighborhood of $4 for a mandrel, which is simply a simple steel straight tool with graduated sizes on it that you can wrap your coils around. This is so much more sophisticated for the same money. It's just something you should have in your kit in case you ever want to use it.
I don't know if anybody knows this, but literally since the day that the very first Coil Master came out, I don't think I've made a coil without using one. I now have two of them because I have the original, you know, kind of skinny one, and now I have the more recent one. And it's like, once you start using them, you're just ruined, because you're people with OCD like me who love looking at a perfectly perfect coil. Just, it makes me so happy, like, that I can't deal with it, just a hand wrap, and have, like, these wraps are a little closer and these are further, like, my OCD will go nuts. Like, it doesn't matter if it vapes the same, it's got to look pretty too.
Yeah, absolutely. So, and what I don't think a lot of people realize, and I think you can still do it with this one, is if you use it wrong, and I do stress this isn't the way it's intended to be used. If you push too hard when you're twisting to create the coil, it will force the wire to wrap around itself instead of around the mandrel, you know, like a coil. So what you'll get is a perfect stovetop coil, the one where it just gets bigger and bigger concentric around, and you put a padding of wick behind it. Now, some people like to vape that way. It's something new to try. I encourage you to try it. My very first try on one of these tools, I created an absolutely picture-perfect stovetop because I did it wrong.
You don't ever, I'm like a master with these things now. You never push them together. You just... But the way I think of it is your focus of energy is just straight up and down. All you're doing is rotating. No pressure either this way or this way. It's just rotation. And the other trick is keep your, when you do a half a turn, then you stop it with your finger so that when you're moving your hand, like hold it so it doesn't backspin on you and you get a tighter wrap that way. So you just go, finger, until you're done. And I always do... I do throwaway wraps. So the first wrap is a throwaway wrap, and the last wrap is a throwaway wrap, and then I like to pull them out on both sides till up, so I end up at the number I want. That's just how I do it.
Perfection.
Right. So words of wisdom from Scope. Go finger.
No. What he's describing is
pull
perfection.
All right, listen.
Twist,
you didn't catch the joke.
Oh yeah, no, I did. I'm just trying.
I'm talking to Tiger.
We're ignoring you. Totally.
I hear
ignoring
a go finger till you're done. That's all I'm hearing.
Well, you know,
that's all I'm saying.
That's good advice too. It just doesn't. If you're talking about coiling, if you're talking about something else, it's all good advice.
The really tough choice, Joe, is do you use these two and then the one, or you know?
That's a shocker. The end one is the shocker.
And then you can double it up. You know, like.
Oh my god.
You can play peekaboo like that.
Oh Jesus. We're gonna play. Here's the church. Here's the steeple. Open it up. Seal the paper.
Anyway. No, I'm talking about the Coil Master still. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, okay. All right, anyway.
I'm speechless. I am speechless. Where's Courtney to back me up on this one?
We broke Tiger.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Anyway, seriously, this is from Gearbus, but this is from their New York City warehouse. So it comes really quick. I bought plenty of things from their New York warehouse, and I get real quick. It's normal first class or priority shipping. It comes normally, and it's free. That's the cool part. They still honor the whole free shipping thing as if you were buying from China, which is weird. I do not see how they're selling these out of New York City for free with free shipping. Well, it's like fucking insanity.
And that's the part I missed when we were talking about it at first, Joe. At 4:13, this ships from the U.S. You're not going to be waiting for it for weeks. I mean,
yeah, that's great.
It's an absolute no-brainer. When he hit me up with this deal before he put it up. He says, Tiger, is this a good deal? And I'm like, dude, why haven't you run it by now? Like, why are you even asking me? This is a great deal. So, yeah, absolutely.
Well, no, I asked if it was more of a relevant deal. Because a lot of people are using thicker wire. They're using, you know, like, I don't know if this will work with...
Hey, listen.
People are using
there's
like
still
alien,
a lot of,
you know, there, alien wire and
coils.
And...
There's fancy coils and they're great. Don't get me wrong, but there's still a lot of old school builders like me. I mean, I cut my teeth on Jenny's. For me, a coil is still good quality wire coiled. You know, and there's some great setups out there. Don't get me wrong. There's some really, really fancy wires available now and coils available now. I still think there's something to be said for, you know, old school, just going old school. And there you have it.
And one thing I'll say about that is a regular coil is a lot better for the impatient because all the fancy ones, the ramp time, like I put some really fancy aliens. I didn't make them. They were perfect. And I put them in this thing. And it's like when I'm out here, I just hit the button and I sit there. I just lean on the button for about 10 seconds before I even start bothering to bring it over because it's just like that thing is so big. It's just got to sit there and like cook for a while before it's ready to vape on it.
Seriously, you know? It's like running a diesel engine. You got to warm up those glow plugs before you bother to even start the damn thing.
And a normal coil, like the coil of my Rio, is instant. Like the second I'm touching this button, it's vaporizing. You know, so it's the jury's still out if you really can taste the difference. A lot of times, it's But anyway.
All right. So speaking of GearBest, there is a one-year anniversary sale going on, which is pretty incredible. I was gonna yuck it in the room. I'm sure Big Bam is on it too as well. This one you gotta really check out. The cool thing about this is they do actually have 100% off sales. I'm not lying. Free. Well, it's not free. It's a penny. Sometimes they have them running. Now I'm looking at it right now. And Tiger, remember that coil winder you were talking about? The one you like? The one you actually like to use?
Okay, there we go. I'm unmuted. You must be talking about the mandrel style, where it's very simple. It's a very simple tool. It's actually comes from jewelry making, where you wind wire for jewelry to make little loops. And it's like, I don't have one with me. I didn't bring my rebuilding stuff. It's a simple, straight metal tool with graduated sizes on it. And, you know, I love the fancy coilers, but I'm old school. I'm in my 40s, okay? It's hard to teach an old dog new tricks. That's what I reach for when I want to build quick. I'll be honest.
My example was that's a buck.
Oh, that's a great deal. I spent like way more than that on
it. And they have a real, like, you know, like the top, like 1 cent to 99 cent area.
Yeah.
They have for RX200, they have a silicone sleeve, which I actually had one of them in green, but this one's red and black. They work, they make your RX200 look really great. If you have a really crappy, like, teal and white one, ugh, I hate those. Those are only 99 cents, but they have a ton of other shit going on. Now, if you're in the United States, and you want to get it quick, go on the side, you'll see these whole things, and you'll see a whole menu. And one says USA Warehouse, click that, or US Warehouse, and you'll go down. They have RX200, $39.59, shipped free. They got K-boxes for $15, shipped free. They have, oh, that one's over. That was a good deal. They actually had Kanger replacement heads for $6, shipped free, but that's over with. They got cotton for $2. They got all kinds of good stuff going on in the United States area. But again, if you're in the EU, like the EU section, that's also going to be free shipping for you in the EU. But shipped from the EU, so it's going to be quicker. You don't have to wait. Now, of course, if you just want to look at, you know, the China stuff and you don't mind waiting, they got a ton of great deals. Stuff that are 50% off, stuff that are just 99 cents. They got all kinds of e-juice. Now, I know he's like, oh, I'm buying e-juice from China. Yes, because a lot of American juice makers are shipping their shit over to China because of what's going on with the regs. So if you like the Muffin Man, they have all that stuff. They have all kinds. They have Halo. All kinds of crazy juices that are going on over there right now. And you're going to see a lot more of this, guys. Once August hits, you're going to be buying a lot of your newer juices from China. Not being China-made, but a lot of the USA juice makers are going to be giving recipes over to China, having China make it, and then you're going to be buying it from them because they're outside of the regulations. Just keep that in mind. So if you're worried that you're not going to be able to find new juices, of course you will.
I'm wondering how aggressive the FDA will be. Like, will they try to seize shipments?
No, because there's nothing in the regs about buying it overseas. It's all about you can't come up with a new flavor. You can buy anything you want overseas.
All right.
You know, there's not a rule. There's no rules about buying anything overseas.
That'd be
really I'm aware of.
Yeah, if that's true, that'll be a really good thing.
You know, China's just going to own everything. But I mean, it's just.
No, what happens in August is that it puts a freeze on new stuff, mods and juice. Nothing new after August 4th or whatever the date is can be released because it's like that's the date that the regs are officially in. So that means anything new comes out has to actually be technically approved first.
Hey, Scope, let me ask you something. If you came out with Mad Scope version 2 in September, how the fuck are they going to know you did that?
Well, I'm a tiny...
No, my point is how the fuck are they going to know you did that? That's my point. They can't enforce that.
Well,
like,
I hear your point, Joe, but Mad Scope requires no version 2.
My point is, though...
There won't be a version 2.
Prove it. I mean, if... you have new juice. Well, I was working on it in June. Prove it. Please. Yeah.
I did have the idea of just creating a bunch of placeholder names. All I have to really do is come up with names and an initial recipe, like a V1, and I could always quietly improve it and get it right later on.
Yeah, you and a lot of people. And I mean, this whole plan is what I like to refer to as a cat bylaw. I used to work in municipal government. We talked about the cat bylaw, not as a real thing, but as an example of legislation that is impossible or completely impractical in the real world to enforce. And, like herding cats. Apparently, according to an old Super Bowl ad, only IBM can herd cats. So all I'm saying is it's next to unenforceable.
Yeah, it's, laws require enforcement. If you can't enforce it, it's not a law. And like I said, everything new will just come out of other countries. And you'll just buy them from other countries. It's that simple. That's it. Now, question though. I mean, there's so many. How about this? If the new product was made in another country and you brought it in to sell, is that considered... Like, if they came out with a Mutation X version 7 atomizer in September, and a vape shop brings it in, well, is that...
That's where they get you, would be the vape shop bringing it in. Like, you maybe could mail order it from China directly, and maybe they won't be able to step on that, but if the shop tries to carry it, I think they're gonna have something to say about it. That's what I think.
Well, what about if China just forges papers and said, we came out with this a year ago? You know what I mean? Like, I'm sure China's not stupid.
Yeah.
It'll be like, oh, yeah, here's papers with it that shows it came out a year ago.
Yeah, the FDA doesn't strike me as the group that's really up on their mods, that they're going to know, like, oh, no, you had the B2. I had the B2, not the B6, you know. Whatever.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I don't believe it. You know, quite frankly, I believe this is all bluster. It's the 2 years from now we have to worry about. But I'm hoping all the lawsuits will change that. But it doesn't even matter. Even the hardcore 2 years from now, you can still buy from other countries.
Yeah, and Aussie Mitt brought a good point. December 31st is actually the second big deadline, which is that's when everyone has to submit their lists of all their products, which I don't see myself doing. So I'll probably go bye-bye by then unless, hopefully I could find someone else to, someone big to pick it up and take over.
Oh, no, you just, it's called email. Hey, listen, you got that Manscope?
Well,
yeah. Okay.
If I continue, it would be something along those lines if I could go that route. But, I mean, it would be nice to hook up with somebody. But, I'm in talks with a couple people, but nothing is...
But that's
really
juice, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, everybody will just be into, most of your people will be into wholesale. And what have you. And like I said, it's already starting. You can already see it. When you could buy Halo from GearBest, there's a reason for that.
Yeah. 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 I noticed when they had like the Milkman or whatever, like I was surprised to see that a couple months ago. I was like, whoa, what's going on there?
Yeah. There's always going to be ways around. Listen, I can still buy cigarettes right now in the mail. I got my cigarettes. And the FDA can open the package and look at it and go, oh, those are Marlboros. But if I put this in the mail and on it it said personal lubricant, there's absolutely no way for them to know that this is e-juice because there's no on-the-spot nick test. It doesn't exist. It requires beakers and acids. You got to look for the meniscus, and you got to put in. It's insanity. So, you know, it's not like it's drugs where they pour, you know, they put it in, they snap it, and it turns blue. Okay, cocaine. It doesn't work like that with e-juice. You know what I mean? So it's just like, what are you selling them? Well, it's personal adult lubricant. Okay, awesome. And it's called Manscope.
Yeah.
And quite frankly, Tiger will take
tastes,
that.
And it tastes divine. It's one of the few. It's one of the few juices that when I load my atomizer, if a little drip ends off on the outside, I lick it off.
Hey, there's some people out there that want their private parts to smell like oatmeal cookies, you know?
Oh my goodness, don't even get me started.
Vaping? I don't know what vaping is. I'm
vaping? Personal, what are you talking? There's nothing
I'm in the personal lubrication business, you know? I have very demanding customers.
That's right. Vapor... Vapor, yeah, vaporlubes or whatever.com. Yeah. All right, so I have another, so we were talking about the Gear Best Sale. Get over there, check it out. I don't know how long this is going to be going, but they have some really great deals. And if you're looking for like art, especially like on the RX 200s, they're really, really good deals from the EU and the United States and from China, all around $39, all free shipping no matter where you live. Along with a bunch of other stuff out there. Lots of Addies and RTAs, RDAs, all that good stuff. So get over there, check it out. All right, so I got another one for you. The Tesla Stealth. Now, I've been thinking about picking one of these up. So what is the Tesla Stealth? Well, basically what it is it reminds me a lot of this, the hydroponic. Fuck, the hydrographic. I keep calling it the hydroponic, the hydrographic. And what the hydrographic is basically a 100 watt box mod. It's simple, set it, forget it. There's no screen, there's no nothing. What it does is it hides your tank inside it. So it could be something as small as, something as small as like the Nugget. But the tank isn't sitting up top, it's sitting inside it. And it's a true stealth mod, in my opinion. It's going to be smaller with the tank than, say, a Nugget with a tank on top of it. Okay? It comes in a bunch of little colors. They're cool, black, white, and red. 220, and the mAh ratio on this is a little bit higher. It's 2,200 mAh. It goes about as high as 100 watts. Goes to down 0.1 ohms, so anything basically you're going to do with the tank should work for you. And looking at the picture, that is a great setup to bring out, like when you're going to the movies, you're going to the grocery store. Well, actually, that's not even a mod that's just for portability. That could be an all-day mod, actually, for 2,200 mAh. You may have to charge it at the end of the day, depending on how much you vape. But I that would work for me for at least 5 or 6 hours. What do you think, Zagger?
Oh, well, a 2,200 mod will last quite a while. And I hate to give, like, empirical answers to this because it really depends on the vapor. Somebody who's, like, chain vaping all day long, it's obviously going to wear out quicker. Somebody who vapes in like bursts or little puffs here and there, that's definitely going to last you all day. So it really depends how you use it, what you're running on it, what the resistance of the coil is, and so forth. But now Ernesto says 2,200 mAh will last you 4 hours. Ernesto, again, I would challenge that. It depends how you vape it. 6-8 hours, depending how you vape it. So certainly it's going to last you a while. It's more than an outing vape.
DeMillan says he runs the Clieto on it. Now, question. I thought the Clieto would be a little too short. What do you, is it okay? Do you have to do anything special for it? Or is it just, is the drip tip peak out enough for it to work?
And what I'm really interested in is DeMillan said they are using their TFV4. And that was one of my questions, because the TFV4 is a little bit broader of an atomizer than the standard 22 millimeters. So I wondered if the TFV4 fit. And D. Millen, thank you for letting us know it does. That's a great thing to know, because I know the TFV4 handles a lot of juice. So
it's a little short. I use different drip. Okay. Well, I figured that, because what they have showing right there is like a Pro Tank. You know, the Pro Tank 4 or something like the original Kanger Sub Tank, like one of these. Because you got one of these bad boys on there, which is tall, and then you got the Clietto, which is far shorter, so how is it going to look inside? That was the one thing that was kind of making me like, I don't know if I want this. But now that you said you could use it, I will probably pick one up. However, the price from America, if you use coupon code I love you or VJC, these are only one-time use coupons over at esig.com. But regardless, it's only 5% off. Comes to $21.37, shipped from America. Really, really cool, nifty little device. Like I said, I'm a big fan of these set it and forget it devices, where it's just like something like the Hydrographics, where you just put it on, it just shoots as much as it possibly can to the tank. It makes a wonderful vape. And when you're done, you throw it on the charger, like your cell phone. You know, you just plug it into a micro USB and you're off to the races. You do it overnight or what have you. And, or you could do it in a car. That's the one thing, the advantage of a LiPo, which I really love, is I could charge it in my car. You know what I mean? If I'm going somewhere, leave it in the charger or charge it while I'm vaping. And most of them are pass-through-ish kind of vapes.
What's
and that's
nice
what I really like about them.
I like the ones, there's some mods out there that take 18650s and still have the charging capability, which is, so you kind of have best of both. You can battery change, but if you're stuck in the bind, you can, you know, resort to micro USB charging, which is kind of nice.
That's the one thing my Playboy mod does not have, which annoys me. Takes two 18650s, but it doesn't have a USB charger on it. Like I can you know, pop out the two batteries, but sometimes I'm just like, screw it, I don't have, you know, I how many batteries do I need? I just want to pop it on my charger and just charge it, you know. Like the something like the Cuboid, where you could just, you know, you can keep.
I don't know if this probably. Somebody just mentioned the temperature.
Degrees. It's zowie.
It's 10:14 at night. Yeah, hello.
Isn't this supposed to be a cold in the desert at night?
Eventually, I think not cold, but it gets cooler, but it takes, you know what it is? The ground sucks in that heat for so long all day. It takes a long time for it to release that heat, finally get rid of it.
Yeah, I went to Arizona.
There's a delay factor.
I went there, man. I don't understand how anybody can live there. I don't get it. It's just hot.
Yeah, I don't think I could. And it's funny because culturally I love it. Like where I am, this area, Mill Ave, is really cool. Like really cool restaurants, and shops. There's a vape shop called Butt Out. Good name. But I just, the heat and the desert vibe. I'm too used to the green. I like seeing trees and grass. You know, that green stuff that people have.
Yeah, it's just,
you don't
hot
see
down
grass
there.
Here.
Oh man, I was down there in probably like 2008. Oh, the sun just leans on you, like it's on your shoulders, and you just fuck you, sun.
You
get scorpions everywhere, and like for those of you who don't live in Arizona, scorpions are like equivalent of our like fucking like squirrels.
we were joking today because there's still a lot of people that smoke in my company too, that the smokers could just go outside and just go like this and just wait. And then starts like the sun would just ignite the cigarette and they could just start
catch
smoking.
Fire.
Like, that's how hot it is. Yeah, it'll just catch fire. Just hold it out there for a second and it'll light up. It's brutal.
Now, just to answer a question in chat, Shameless Trouble, I am muted unless you hear my voice. So if Joe's echoing, blame him for being so loud, he's bouncing off the walls.
Echo. Stop. The fuck? I guess she wants to be part of the show.
I don't know. I didn't say the magic words, so I don't know what set her off. But yeah, Joe's got these automated home things that just make life more difficult, to be honest. But
they're saying I'm echoing, but I'm wearing headphones, so I don't see how I could possibly.
Well, you are actually, because when we're talking, we could see the sound bar. Like when I'm talking to you, I could see your sound bar moving.
My mic can hear what's coming out of my headphones. That's interesting.
It's a laptop thing. It happens. It's not the end of the world.
Yeah. Well, I can hop off if you know.
Oh, no, it's fine. You're good to shit. We're done here in 12 minutes.
You
anyway.
Hop off when you're ready and not until.
I'm probably going to go to sleep soon. I'm still on like East Coast time. I don't really ever change when I come out here. So to me, it's 11:01, 1:18. It's like, yeah, I can fall asleep.
Yeah, definitely. But like I said, we only got 12 minutes. So.
Oh, okay.
Condensation wants to know what you named your Echo. That's his ego, the same ego that has coffee and breakfast with him in the morning.
You can call them three names now. You can call them Amazon, you can call them Alexa, and then the other one, and I can't say it, ECHEO, because she'll go off. Hey, Scope, remember that thing I was like, hey, play a fart sound?
Mm-hmm.
That's changed now. And I really believe it's because of the cub. It actually mm-hmm. has its
he
own
broke
app
it for
now
everybody.
For farting. Like you actually
oh, you have
to
add
download
the
a new
app.
App, like yeah. A skill that she could do.
Yeah. It's not that
well,
it's broken. It's that the cub has asked for it so many times. I swear to God, they've seen so many responses or requests for it that they built a new app just for that. I'm not even kidding you.
Yeah. The first time I tried it, it played it, and it, ironically, I think it's the exact same fart that I have in my soundboard machine that I use for the shows. And then the next time I tried it, it said, you currently don't have fart sounds in your library, which I thought was really funny. So I'll have to try it again and see if I can figure out the app.
It's a skill now. You have to actually get, you know, you could do Echo, could have skills.
Yeah.
When you go through the thing. So now you have to teach her how to fart.
Yeah. I turned you guys down in my headphones, so I'm hoping that maybe helps cut out whatever leakage we're getting.
Leakage. That sounds all kinds of wrong.
Yeah, it sounds all kinds of wrong and gross. Well, actually, at 100 degrees, there's probably going to be leakage from somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, that's the other thing. It sucks for the vapors out here, because... with this kind of weather, your tanks, it just wreaks havoc on your tanks. Like, this thing, I had the juice control all the way closed. And I guess just from going outside and it getting really hot and vaping on it and then closing it and then going inside with the air conditioning, and they got the air conditioning like cranked to brutal inside. It's actually too cold inside. I think that severe temperature change made this thing, the juice found a little way out of it. Like, even with the thing closed. So I have to be careful with the tanks out here.
Yeah, it's got to do with the air pressure. You come out of a cold environment into a really, really warm one. It's the same reason that when I was traveling through the mountains a couple summers ago, doing the drive back to the inland from the coastal area of BC, I had to literally take my tanks and set them upside down in the cup holder so that the airflow was open, so that it could equalize as I was going up and down through the mountains. It was pretty crazy, but you know, different pressure, right?
I used to do that on the plane. If you know, back in the day when I would like actually have, now I've gotten smarter and I just empty my tanks for the plane. But back in the day, I used to ride them in the pocket in front of me like this in the plane, so that when we'd ascend and descend, the pressure difference, it could go work itself out through the air holes without the liquid actually coming with it, you know?
Yep.
So that, like, K-Fun days, I used to do that.
Yeah, exactly.
So how did they deal with you when flying with liquids? Because people were saying, oh, we can't put liquids on planes anymore. Everything okay?
Everything was fine, although this is the first time because I've flown a bunch of times as a vapor, but this is the first time they had me step aside, not, like, privately or anything. But he just wanted to look in my backpack, and what he was curious about or what they flagged was I had three sets of 18650 LG Browns in battery boxes, so two per box. I had three boxes, and they wanted to see those for some reason. I don't, you know,
should have told
which is kind of odd because they see a lot of batteries, you know. But I don't know. That's he wanted to look at the batteries, and then they did the usual that little square that they rub it around your bag. And then they put it in a machine, and it senses, like, if I had worked with any explosives or anything, it would go crazy. But, you know, it came back clean, so they just let me on my way. But I did the usual thing. I had a little quart-size Ziploc with I had exactly these four in there, and they didn't give me
anything. You know what I want to find out? And I don't think this has ever happened. Has the TSA ever, like, found somebody going through the TSA with explosives, like one time? The airport in Istanbul blown up. There's like 60 people dead, right? 40 injured. Has any of the security ever caught somebody going through? Ever?
I would imagine they must have. I mean, I know I noticed on the way here, like when I landed here and I was walking through the terminal. I saw a lot of cops around these two people that, like, they must have been trying to bring something through that they weren't happy about, because there was, like, five or six cops all standing around them. I had to keep walking, so I didn't get a good look, but I was like, interesting, you know.
I'm looking at Anti-Hero's avatar. Anti, you've gotten quite a tan, sir. Yeah, Shaquille O'Neal is just... But seriously, like, have they ever if they caught somebody with explosives and Uzis going through, that they would have announced that. They'd talk about that. I've never heard that one time.
Yeah, Anti made a good point. The illusion of security theater. Yeah, you know, I hate to say it, but some of the people doing this job are not the sharpest tools in the toolbox. So it's like a little
sharp
scary.
As a sack of wet mice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, these things happen. But, you know, I've gone through security a billion times. You take your shoes off. You do this. Everybody goes through. It takes forever, and they never catch one fucking person. But then, like, you know, what they do is they just, if you're gonna blow people up, they just do it before they get on the plane. Now they just go into a place where everybody's standing in line for the ticketing or trying to put their stuff on board, and they just blow themselves up there. You know, so what are they going to start doing? Are they start going to, like, the moment you walk in, you got to go through
security? I read a little bit about the attack today, and they did that all around the arriving area where there is no security. So now they're talking about what are they going to do now? Push security out so that you can't even – you have to go through some crazy thing in your car before you can even enter. Like, that would be a huge pain in the ass if they have to do that, you know?
Yeah, and the funny thing is just say they even did that. Just say you have – excuse me, you have to go through security the moment you walk into the airport. So fine, they'll just drive up with a van full of explosives right outside the airport and blow it up. You know, like, it's like, you can't stop this shit. If somebody wants to kill you, there ain't nothing you can do about it. You know, that's just how it is.
I just got a link from BBB to, like, the top 10 good catches of 2011. One was snakes, turtles, and birds. inert landmines. That's interesting. A stun gun disguised as a smartphone. Flare gun with 7 flares. That's interesting. 2 throwing knives. 1,200 firearms. Loaded 380 pistol. Strapped to a passenger's ankle. You guessed it. He forgot it was there. Small chunks of C4 explosives were found in the passenger's checked luggage. Believe it or not, he was bringing it home to show his family. So,
C4 won't do anything unless it's, you know, set off to go off. I mean, you could set C4 into Play-Doh, and that's all.
Yeah, I saw the whole Mythbusters on that, and they were dropping shit on it and stuff. And, like, yeah, it's surprisingly benign until you give it that little shock that it needs, you know.
And then, a small little chunk will take out, like, a quarter panel of a plant.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, that's kind of dark and sinister to think about.
What?
But, well, the whole the whole thing you were just talking about that's dark and sinister.
Oh, okay.
But it is 1:27 past the hour. We have 3 minutes till the bottom of the hour. Of course, at the bottom of the hour, DC will be taking over the broadcast to bring you jammies and juice with lots of DIY talk, lots of general vaping, lots of more deals. So those of you who love deals, DC loves deals just as much as we do. And he's got some of them to share with you. But until then, do we have any questions or any more deals you want to share, Joe?
I have a question. How are babies made?
Well, that is a topic for after we drop the broadcast, my darling.
It's a little magic show where you make something special disappear, but then you decide you don't want to make it disappear anymore. But then you decide you want to make it disappear again, and yeah.
Okay, that's a great
suggestion. Very enlightening. Thank you, Scope, for that look into the birds and the bees.
Yeah, I tried to dumb it down for everybody.
The stork comes, gives you anal until the baby shows up.
Oh my god!
Storks have anal, and then a baby shows up.
Did you ever see the one? It was from Family Guy, and the stork shows up, and he flies in. He's got this Barry White voice. He's like real deep, and he takes the. He's like, oh my god, you're gonna bring me my baby, and he takes her light bulb, and then takes another light bulb and puts it in. And it's red, and it goes over and he goes. No, you're gonna make the baby.
Ermager.
Awesome for Family Guy. I didn't do that one justice, but it is fucking hilarious. Big Bam Boom has it, doesn't he? Yeah, there it is.
Awesome.
Joe has a Family Guy problem.
I love Family Guy.
I'll just share that with you guys.
Family Guy. You know. Who doesn't love Family Guy? I mean, come on. That's where I get half my material. Anyway, guys.
Oh, well, that explains a lot of things.
Yeah, it does.
Jeez.
Anyway.
All right. Well, Big Bam has the links for you there for the Vaping Deals and Steals Facebook group, of course, and the Vaping Underground Forum. If you haven't signed up, you need to. Great resource to connect with other vapers and learn about all things vaping and a lot of things that have nothing to do with vaping. Thanks, Big Bam.
Yes, guys. And we will see you next week on Mod Envy. Well, this week on Mod Envy. Hopefully we'll have some something to talk about. I'm sure we'll come up with something.
There's always something to talk about.
Yes.
And I want to say thank you so much, Scope, for joining us tonight. This is so fun. We love having you guest with us on Done Deal. And I'm so glad you could be our... what do you call it? Correspondent, our long-range correspondent from Arizona tonight.
Yes, direct via satellite.
Yes.
Back in the day.
Luckily, the hotel Wi-Fi held up well enough to be able to make it happen, so thanks for having me. It was fun.
Yes, and next week, Done Deal. I'm not sure if we're going to be doing Done Deal next week, only because we are going out before 4th of July, and I don't know how good the Wi-Fi is going to be out in the place we're going to be at, so I don't know if Done Deal is going to be on. But we'll try to do it if we can.
Alrighty. Well, with that said, we will bid you guys good night. And thank you for joining us. Stay tuned. There'll be a brief break while we wait for YouTube to figure out that there's two different streams going on. And then DC will be back with you. Just enough time for a really quick bathroom break and to restock your snacks and drinks. Stay with VU Live. Thanks for being with us. Good night.
John Q.
Penis.
Vagina.